We opened the centre in 1991, but it started about a year and a half before that, where we, nine women, got together with a local nun, and we trained as local women in the area, living in the area, and we were trained up in community development, and you know, we learned skills around community or committee skills and things like that, so that when we opened up the centre, that we would be, you know, experienced enough to welcome women in. Years back, you know, when we first started to address that, the issue of domestic violence, women would have kept it sort of hidden more. You know, it didn't bring it out and say out that it was happening to them. So to try and address that, then we set up a domestic violence forum, with Footprints playing a leading role in that. Also, with our staff and our volunteers, we would have set up training with Women's Aid, you know, on awareness of the effect of domestic violence on women, and then separately on children, and then together as a family unit as well. You know, so we were always trying to raise awareness of the issue of domestic violence.
People having a power over another person in a relationship.
Like not letting them do stuff for them. Like letting them out of your house and all.
And telling them what to do and where to go, and just being really controlling.
Often when women come in and they've been experiencing domestic violence, people come in at different stages, and it might be that they're still living with a domestic violence relationship, which can be extremely distressing for people. And at Footprints here, we offer what we call a one-stop shop on a regular basis, where we get a lot of the agencies in that a woman might need to come and speak to, including the solicitor, benefits advice, housing advice, Women's Aid, and ourselves are here as well. And it's just, if someone's still in the house with a violent person, it might be difficult for them to get to all those different agencies. And that just allows them the chance to come out and find information. And it might be that they don't make a decision on the day, it doesn't commit them to anything. We give out personal alarms. These are little alarms that can be just put on someone's key ring. And you know, if someone's walking along, they can hold the keys in their hand. And if they see the perpetrator, they can just pull it off. Another thing that we give out to women regularly, especially if they feel unsafe in their home, are these doorstop alarms. They're really great. They can just be put under people's front doors or back doors. And then, you know, because so many women would say to us, I feel really afraid to go to sleep at night. I can't sleep because I'm just worried that he's going to break in and I'll just, you know, not wake up.
Domestic violence affects young people massively, especially I work with very young children, and you would see it very much with them. They become withdrawn, don't trust people, worry about other people, can affect their whole personal, social and overall development, so it has a massive effect on them.
I would say to them to speak to someone, speak to a close friend, speak to a family member, speak to someone in their school, speak to a teacher, because there is a lot of support out there. A lot of teachers are now being trained in the area of domestic abuse. There's staff training going on in all organisations. But definitely go and speak to someone, you're not on your own. There's also the free phone number, Women's Aid helpline number, that a young person can ring, and they've now just changed that you can ring that from a mobile. It used to be a landline number. You can now ring that from a mobile. So definitely speak to someone and don't have that problem on your own. Share it.
Tell him or her to go and talk to like a counsellor or get help, or try and talk them into getting help and being free and stuff. Go get help. Tell your family member or close friend to go get help, and there is a way out.